Nuna will keep an eye on this story for us. Now, not so many men would be too eager to embrace vasectomy as a means of family planning, but not so for Dr. Charles Ochieng, a premier vasectomist practicing in Kenya and East Africa. 10 years ago, the medical practitioner took this path and is now on the forefront of advocating for men to take up this alternative means of family planning. And as KTN's Elfas Lagat reports, a team of vasectomists will converge in Nairobi from Monday next week to demystify myths around the exercise and perform vasectomies for free.
2008 marked the turning point for Dr. Charles Ochieng. He decided to undergo vasectomy, which he says was a necessary step, albeit not so easy for his family, especially his wife.
I did it in 2008, that's almost 10 years ago. And the main reason was we had had 2 children already, but the method my wife was using was giving us some health challenges. So that's why I decided to look for a doctor, which was very difficult to get a doctor to perform it for me. But I had to wait for a doctor who had gone to Ethiopia for some training. So when he came back after 6 months, I had my vasectomy.
The health practitioner, with a characteristic pleasant demeanor, tries to explain why many men shy away from taking part in this procedure.
Reception was very negative because we realized that men are very ignorant about vasectomy. They have very little information about it. You know, they equate it to castration, like the one for bulls and rams. Okay, vasectomy itself is about 2,000 years old. When it started, doctors could use the scalpel. The scalpel is just like a knife where you open the scrotum, get the vas deferens, and get the vas deferens. But then it was realized that its safety was not that good because there are incidences of bleeding, infection, swellings. But then now, with time now, doctors have invented a very refined technique where we don't use scalpels, we don't use the knife now.
Vasectomy has been touted as an alternative means of family planning to help alleviate some of the side effects that women go through when they undergo family planning methods such as implantation. But the question is, are men willing to undergo vasectomy? On the other hand, are women willing to let their men undergo vasectomy? Let us find out.
Ways to plan family, but a vasectomy is a no. Yeah, I think there are birth control pills that you can use. There are some condoms and some other methods that you can use to control birth, but vasectomy, no.
This issue that has generated a heated debate, with some clergymen flatly opposed to the whole idea of family planning.
Whoever introduced it went against the will and the thought of God, because the thought of God is to allow us to fill the earth. We are supposed to subdue, we are supposed to fill the earth. But now you see, when you do a male family planning, you're reducing and you're refusing the continuity of God, the growth and the expansion of God.
The 4-day event set for Monday 23rd to the 26th of April will be hosted by Family Health Options Kenya. Elfas Lagat, KTN News, Nairobi.
So there's such a heated debate on this. So have you heard from men of God and just Kenyans talking about this? And we'd like to pick your mind on it as well tonight. So we're asking you a big question tonight. Do you support calls for men to embrace vasectomy as an alternative way of family planning? Do you support calls for men to embrace vasectomy as an alternative way of family planning? Please start with a yes or no. And tweet us at KTN News, at KTN Kenya. You can also tweet me at Linda Ogutu. You can also send a message to the number 22155. I'd love to just read some of your thoughts on this, even as we wait for Monday to come. So...